September 11 profoundly changed American politics, at least for a time. What we witnessed in the months after the attacks was a political dynamic as old as the American Republic. When the country feels imperiled, the White House gains in power, and Congress loses it. That happens for both policy and political reasons. Most Americans and most lawmakers believe that during a crisis, strong presidential leadership is necessary. But again, a political factor also operates. Legislators who might be concerned at what the president's doing worry that if they criticize the White House, they'll be labeled as unpatriotic and as a result suffer at the ballot box. So after September 11th, President Bush began to dominate the political landscape, whether it was an issue like the passage of the USA Patriot Act, rules on how to interrogate and handle detainees, the creation of a new large Department of Homeland Security, or invading Iraq. His policy preferences carried the day, and Congress was clearly in the background. But as the memories of 9/11 receded and the public became increasingly disenchanted with the outcome of President Bush's policies, his public approval ratings began to fall, and America returned to a more normal state of politics. Lawmakers who had previously bit their tongue now began to criticize the president. Indeed, for many Democrats, saw a political opportunity that would rally their own constituencies if they criticized the president. So by the time we get to 2005, 2006, we see a more assertive Congress, which is trying to put its mark on policy, both foreign and domestic. This more assertive Congress, however, finds that it is easier to give away power to the White House than it is to recapture it, as Congress discovered most clearly, perhaps, on the surge in Iraq, where a determined President Bush was able to increase the number of U.S. troops going to Iraq over the objections of what appeared to be a majority of lawmakers on Capitol Hill. As we come now, a decade after September 11th, and just months after the killing of Osama bin Laden, terrorism is no longer the defining feature of American policy or politics. The new defining issue is how to put America's fiscal house in order. So in that sense, the era of terrorism has given way to the era of fiscal austerity. And as we go forward, we now have American politics that looks more normal, that is much more focused inward, and features much more heated battles between Capitol Hill and the White House.